What's up guys, my name is Ace, and today I wanted to investigate something that I've been curious about since the launch of Modern Warfare 2, and that is, are there duplicate attachments in the game, essentially attachments that do literally the exact same thing, even though they're classified as different attachments for the same gun? This is something I noticed particularly in the muzzle section, so that's what we're going to be focusing on today. When you scroll through that list, you might notice there are several muzzles that look identical when it comes to their stated pros and cons, as well as the stat bars themselves. When you swap between these attachments, those stat bars don't move at all. Are they actually the exact same thing, just with a different look and a different name attached to it, or do they have different effects? And the whole reason I have to test this to begin with is the fact that we don't have advanced stats in the game, and anybody that's been playing Call of Duty long enough should know that those stat bars can't be fully trusted to be completely accurate, and they're oftentimes going to be misleading. So with this video, I did a bunch of testing with the recoil plots just to see if there are any differences between these attachments that appear to be identical. Keep in mind with this video, I did have to keep things reasonable, so I did just test with one gun here. These attachments may work different with different classes of weapons. But in either case, let's first focus on the muzzle attachments that help with horizontal as well as vertical recoil control in that order. So when you look at the pros list, horizontal will be above vertical. And with the M4, we have three muzzles that do this exact same thing, and it's worth noting the stat bars are identical for all three of these. We have the X10 Havoc 90, the FTAC Castle Comp, and the RF Crown 50. As far as we can tell based on the menus, these are literally the exact same attachment, with just a slightly different look to it, and also a different method to unlock them. And when we have a look at their recoil comparisons here, keep in mind there's always going to be at least a little bit of randomness with recoil. It's not like you get literally the exact same plot every single time in this game. This is what we end up with. And taking a look at that, they do look very similar. However, if you take a really close look, you might see some different trends there. And to take this to the next step, to be a little bit more scientific with this at least, I realize this isn't like a full-on scientific study, but for a daily upload sort of a video where we're just looking at trends, what I did is I just drew a red box around each of the recoil plots that maps out the total vertical as well as horizontal magnitude of each of these recoil plots. And for a cleaner look, and to give you a better comparison where everything's equalized here, this is what we end up with our three recoil plots with each of these. And when we take a look at this, when it comes to the Havoc 90 as well as the Castle Comp, they seem pretty comparable. Obviously, there's that little bit of randomness, but on average, they seem to be about the same, whereas the RF Crown 50 definitely seems to have a lot less horizontal recoil on average compared to the others. Now, of course, I wanted to take this a step further and actually quantify this. So what I did here is in Photoshop, I was able to measure the exact size based on pixels of the height and the width of each of these squares, so we can get an actual numerical comparison here. And I took the average of these three plots for each of them, and as we can see here, the RF Crown 50 appears to be noticeably better than the other two when it comes to our horizontal recoil control. And this doesn't appear to be just a small margin that could be explained by the slight random deviation in recoil. This is a significant difference compared to the other two. Whereas when it comes to the vertical recoil control averages, they're all much more comparable, although the Castle Comp is a little bit better than the other two when it comes to vertical, but not by the same sort of margin as we saw with the RF Crown 50's horizontal recoil control. And as a result, it looks like even though these appear completely identical in the menus, there's very likely at least some minor differences between these three attachments, most notably with the RF Crown 50. And honestly, after doing this testing, I think I'm going to be leaning much more toward that compared to the others if I'm looking for this style of recoil control, which is horizontal first and vertical second. Although again, just to be clear, I've only tested with one gun here, and I could have a larger sample size of recoil plots as well. And I think in the future, I may consider diving deeper into this where I test across multiple weapon classes with more recoil plots for a better sample size there so we can get better overall results here. But I think there's still a small part of me that's holding out hope that they're just gonna give us the advanced stats at some point down the road. And in that case, I wouldn't have to do any additional testing because we'd see the numbers for ourselves. But at least based on what I'm seeing here, I'm definitely gonna start leaning more toward that Crown 50 muzzle. Now, I didn't wanna leave it at that. I also wanted to test the multiple attachments we have that affect vertical recoil control first and then horizontal recoil control. And with this, we once again have three of these muzzles for the M4. The first one is the FJX Fulcrum Pro. Then the second one is the Cronin OP44. And you might notice when you transition between those two, You actually get a little bit more recoil control according to the stat bars when you swap over to the Cronin OP44, so it looks like these do have some coded differences in them. But then when we swap over to the third attachment here, this one appears to be identical to the Cronin OP44. This is the second tread 40. So let's once again have a look at our recoil plot comparison here with the M4. And at first glance, they may appear fairly comparable here, although it looks like there's more randomness with that FJX Fulcrum Pro. And the second tread appears to be maybe a little better than the others when it comes to overall consistency with recoil. But let's once again draw those red boxes around each of these recoil plots. And then we'll just equalize these as well as add those values with the sizes of each of these rectangles. And with this one, there's a couple little outlier stats here. When it comes to horizontal recoil control, the Fulcrum Pro and the Tread 40 are essentially identical, whereas the Cronin OP44 definitely has more overall horizontal recoil than the other two based on these tests. Whereas when it comes to vertical recoil control, the Fulcrum Pro and OP44 are identical when it comes to their averages with this, whereas the second Tread 40 is noticeably better than both of these based on these plots. And as a result, if I had to choose between these three, I'd go with the second Tread 40, which is already what I tend to lean toward because I've done lots of recoil testing in the past. And the second Tread 40 always seemed to be a standout attachment when it comes to this, and this just further supports that. And as a result, when we look at this testing that I've done, even though attachments may appear literally identical in the menus based on the stat bars as well as the pros and cons, I do believe there are some slight differences in the coded values that are being used here. Also, one thing I almost forgot to include, so I'm just gonna sort of fit it in here. These are the aim down sight times for each of these because all of these muzzles harm our aim down sight speed. And based on my hand testing at least, which isn't 100% flawlessly accurate, but based on my hand testing, all of these appear to give us the exact same aim down sight values at 290 milliseconds with the M4. And after seeing these results, I definitely want to dive deeper into this topic, and I think it's time for me to start working on some very detailed analysis of each of the muzzle attachments as well as underbarrel grip attachments. This will have to be done in multiple videos since there's just going to be so much work going on in the back end. But for those, I will use a much larger sample size with my recoil plots, and I will test across multiple weapon categories as well, because these might behave totally different on an SMG versus an assault rifle versus an LMG, and I want to make sure we can get potentially even exact coded values with very careful hand tests. So please let me know in the comments below if that's something you'd be interested in seeing, because I am willing to put the work in. It's just going to be a lot of work, and it will take me quite some time to get that all done. But just a quick recap of today's video, if you are going for a muzzle that helps with horizontal first, vertical second, I'd go with that RF Crown 50 just based on these results, even though it could potentially change depending on the gun. Whereas if you're going for vertical first, horizontal second, that is where I'd lean much more toward the second Tread 40. And with that, I am curious to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Were you surprised by these results? Were you surprised that some of these attachments that appear to be identical aren't necessarily identical on the back end? And will this affect your attachment choices at all? Just let me know down below. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating is always appreciated. And don't forget to subscribe for more if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys next time.